नमस्ते चिल्ड्रन, वेलकम टू अनदर सेशन ऑफ आवर चैप्टर वेदर क्लाइमेट एडॉप्टेशंस इन प्लांट्स एंड एनिमल्स। सो इन आवर अर्लियर क्लास वी केम टू नो व्हाट इज वेदर एंड क्लाइमेट। वेदर इट इज एन एटमॉस्फेरिक कंडीशंस ऑफ एन एरिया फॉर अ शॉर्ट टर्म ड्यूरेशन दैट इज डे टू डे। सच एटमॉस्फेरिक कंडीशंस ऑफ डे टू डे ऑफ ए प्लेस इट इज कॉल्ड योर वेदर। वेर एज वेन इट कम्स टू योर क्लाइमेट it is also the atmospheric conditions of an area, but it is a long term duration, means some years. So from some years in that specific time period, if it is too high temperatures are noticed, we are saying that this is the area where the in this area in these months high temperatures are noted, so it's a summer season. If it is too rainfall in few months in that area, then we are saying it as a rainy season. And even same with the winter season. So atmospheric conditions of an area for a long term duration in specified locations, it's called your climate. So now this weather and climate are always and always having some elements are determined by some factors. So in case of your weather, if you will see weather, the main elements that are determining the weather, that is your temperature. What's the temperature of that day? Always this temperature we are expressing in terms of maximum temperature and minimum temperature of a day. Because as it is weather, it's getting changed from one day to other day. Every time the temperature of a day, it is expressed in terms of maximum and minimum temperature. And after that, it is about your precipitation rate, wind and air pressure of that area. Okay, so your wind flow, that is determined by the anemometer. Your air pressure, it is determined. So your precipitation, the precipitation, it is nothing but the water that is falling from the atmosphere on its surface. So that precipitation is one of the main elements, key elements that is determining the weather. And even the humidity levels, that is the amount of water in a form of water vapor, which is measured by the hygrometer, and the rainfall of that area, which is measured by rain gauge. So these are some of the key elements that are determining the weather of that area. When it comes to the factors which are controlling the climate, the first one is altitude, that is the height of that area from the sea level. How much distance it is there, that area is there from the sea level, that is the altitude. And even the latitude is also playing a role, that is the distance of that area from the equator zone, that is also played a role. Yes, along with that, the mountain barriers, how the peaks of that area that are arranged are in between that, what are the different peaks that of mountains are present. And even the ocean currents. Ocean currents means it is about the warm and cold water, especially in the seashore areas. We will see this. Okay, the currents that are water currents that are coming from the warm and cold water are in between this warm and cold water near the seashore areas. That is your ocean currents. Along with that, the heating differences, that land area heating difference from the sea level, that is your sea breeze and land breeze areas of that one. And because of these heating differences, definitely the seashore areas will always and always suffer with typhoons, wind flows. So these are some of the factors which are controlling the climate of that area. Okay, so now after that, based on this weather and climate, animals are bringing some changes in their body. Those are maybe external bodily changes or internal bodily changes, and even a behavior changes that are called our adaptations. Yes, adaptations means it is a change that is brought in the living organism's body or its behavior towards the habitat. So now based on this climate, all the terrestrial zone that is present on this earth, we have categorized into mainly three different regions. One is the polar region, second one is the desert region, and third one is the rainforest region. So these are the main three regions that we have categorized on the earth. One is the polar region where extremely cold climates are noticed, a desert region where extremely very hot high climates are noticed, and the third one is the rainforest region where a plenty of a rainfall, average temperature and all the facilities are available. Rainforest region is the major region where we will see n number of living organisms. So polar region, so today at first we will discuss about this polar region. So polar region, so when we will take this polar region in our brain, immediately that comes to our brain, that is a heavy snowfall and a very 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 less temperatures. This word very less temperatures is indicating minus 37 degrees Celsius and even less than that. So in this particular polar regions, for 6 months there is completely there is no sun at all, and for 6 months there is no sunset. That means 6 months there is no sunrise. Completely in dark areas the animals have to live, and in 6 months there is no daytime, night time. Completely sunrise they will see. So some animals that are living in this polar region, that are your polar bear, penguins, reindeers, whales, seals, Siberian cranes. These are some of the animals that are living in this polar region. So now let us see the different adaptations that are seen in these polar region animals. The first one, that is your polar bear. So what are the different adaptations that we will see in this polar bear? First and foremost one is the skin of this polar bear. In which color it is? It is in white color. So now your snow is also white in color. That means the white fur, it is helping that particular polar bear to happily hide itself in the snow. That particular feature we are saying as a camouflage nature. Okay. And after that, another important feature that we will see, your polar bear, it is having a two-layer fur. That two-layer fur, it is helping the polar bear to protect itself from the extreme cold conditions. Along with that, immediately this skin, immediately below the skin, the polar bear, it is having a thin layer of fat. Now this fat, it is acting as a insulator. So insulator means we all know very well, it's not at all allowing the body heat to come out. And this two layered fur, it is not at all allowing the outer cold temperature to move in it. So in that way, this two layered fur and a fatty layer under the skin is helping the animal to protect itself from the extreme cold conditions. Now let us check the paw. So the paw of the polar bear, if you will notice, it is a widespread paw that is present, which is helping the polar bear to walk very happily and very comfortably in the snow. Along with that, this paw even helpful to swim in the water. And polar bear, it's a very good swimmer. Along with that, polar bear, it is having a very good sense of smell. It will hide in the snow and it can smell up to 1 kilometer or 1.5 kilometer. And it will try to hunt its prey by sensitizing the smell. So these are some of the adaptations that are noticed in the polar bear towards its habitat. So now, whenever we will take the word polar region, a very beautiful and an interesting bird that comes into our brain, that is your ice penguins. It is a flightless bird. It cannot fly. But like a bird, it is having a beak, one pair of legs, a claw. That's what we are calling it as a bird. So now if you will see this polar penguin, so the first and foremost one, the penguin, it will merge in its surroundings with the help of this particular white colored skin fur that is present on the lower side of its body. And the back side of the body, if you will see, it is having a very thick fat content immediately below the skin, which is protecting the penguin from the extreme cold conditions. Along with that, polar penguin, if you will observe, always penguins live in groups. Means these are colonial animals. Animals, if they are living in groups like penguins, ants, insects, these are the colonial animals where these animals always and always live in groups. So that living in group is one of the best feature in case of your penguins to protect themselves from the extreme cold conditions. Yes, along with that, if you will see the feet of the penguin, see, a webbed feet is present. Along with that webbed feet, a curved claw that is noticed, which is helping the penguin to have a good grip when it is walking on the snow. Yes, along with that, as I said, they are colonial animals. Always they will live in group. The huddle of the penguin, when they are when there is an extreme cold wind that is blowing, all the penguins, they will come together and they form a very big wall like structure, which we are saying as a huddle. So now the huddle of the penguin, it always and always helps to stop that cold wind to enter into this another side. So the huddle of the penguin is one of the best adaptations that they will show to protect themselves and the baby penguins from the extreme cold conditions. One, see, let's see how the huddle of the penguins is formed. Yes, children, let's have a look how the penguins, they are forming the huddle. Yes, very beautifully, see how many penguins they are living together. That's what I said, these are colonial animals, and when there is a severe wind blow, see how nicely they are forming the huddle, which definitely keeping them warm so that they can protect themselves from the extreme cold conditions. Okay, so till now we had seen the polar bear adaptations, penguin adaptations. Along with this, some other animals are also present, like the fishes in the polar region. They are helping that fishes of the polar region, they can stay in the water for a longer duration. And even in the screen, if you will see a bird, that is your Siberian crane, it is a bird which lives in the polar region. But during winter season, when there is an extreme cold temperatures are there, that time it cannot survive there. So it will fly for some hundreds and thousand kilometers, and it will come to warm places like our India. And here it will stay for few months. There it will lay eggs, hatch their eggs, and it will the nestlings will come out. It will train the nestlings and carry the nestlings when there is a summer season here. So during extreme winter seasons in the polar region, now the migratory birds like your Siberian crane, yes, they will fly for 1,000 kilometers restlessly, and they will move to warm places like our India. Here they are taking shelter. So during this time we are having winter, yes, so that time they will happily lay eggs here, hatch them and train up their nestlings. And whenever the summer starts in our India, now again, because they can't live in an extreme cold condition, in not even in a extreme hot summer season, so now whenever the summer starts in our India, now the same Siberian crane, it will fly towards its native place. So such type of adaptation, we will call it as a migration. And that migration, it is seen in the birds. So we are saying such particular ones as a migratory birds. We are saying such particular birds as a migratory birds. Best example is your Siberian crane, because India is one of the good place where so many number of migratory birds that will come during winter season. They will stay here up to the summer starting. Happily they will reproduce in these areas because that are the suitable temperatures for their reproduction. They will reproduce here, and whenever the summer it is starting, they will flew to their native places. Migratory birds, they are moving from their native places to warm areas. Again, when there is a summer season in these warm places, they are moving towards the native areas. So migratory birds is also one of the major adaptations that we will see in the polar region birds. Okay, children, so in our next class, let us learn about desert region adaptations. Okay, thank you so much.